Hi everybody, I'm Melanie from Calm Tie Dyes. In this video, I'm going to be folding an 8-point mandala on a tapestry. There are two tapestries that I'm working on, and I'm going to show you the entire process for one of them. And then at the end of the video, we'll take a look at both of them and show you how they turned out. So this is a piece of Kona cotton that I bought at my local fabric store. It is 50 inches by 50 inches. It has been washed and dried, and then I soaked it in soda ash. After I soaked it in soda ash, I hung it to dry. So it is dry. There's no moisture in this fabric at all. The first step is to fold your fabric in fourths. So we're gonna do that first. All right, so I've got it folded in half here. Just kind of smoothing it out as I go. Okay, folded it in half one way, folding it in half now the other way. So I'm turning my big 50-inch square into a 25-inch square. So all I'm doing right now is smoothing out the wrinkles in the fabric. You can iron your fabric with a low heat setting, but when the fabric has soda ash in it, a high heat tends to cause some discoloration of the fabric. So I'm not gonna iron it. I'm just gonna smooth it out as best I can. The little wrinkles in this from spinning out in the washer and hanging to dry won't affect the design at all. You just want to avoid any big creases, so. All right, we've got it folded in fourths. The next step is to fold it like a paper airplane. It's the best way to describe it. So I've got two layers here. Over in this corner, I've got four layers. And then this is kind of where it all comes together here in the center. So this is the center of the mandala. This is where we're gonna start our tying, but first we gotta get it ready for that. So, like I said, paper airplane is the best way to describe it. We're gonna fold this corner up. Turn it here, it's easier to work this way. This is a fairly new fold for me. I have done some smaller mandalas, like on 15 inch by 15 inch squares. And I did a couple of kind of table runner designs where I did a mandala in the center of it and then kind of scrunched it on the ends. But this is the first full size, what I would consider a legitimate full size tapestry that I've done. The edges are unfinished, so I will have to hem the edges once I'm done with this. It'll be about probably 4 feet by 4 feet when it's finished. So this is my first real, like I said, what I would consider a legitimate tapestry. It's the biggest piece of fabric I've worked on to date, and it is new for me. So the mandala is kind of a tricky fold. There's some there's some tricks to it and some challenges. So I apologize if this video gets a little bit tedious at times. You'll have to just kind of suffer along with me as I work through this. So, all right, so I've got the first fold done. I'm gonna fold it again the same way. Again, all the way down to the point here. Line up the edges and smooth out the fabric. This is going to be an 8-point mandala. So this is as far as we fold it for that. If you wanted to do a 16-point, you would just fold this one more time, but I'm not gonna do that today. So 8 points is what we're going for. It's pretty common. All right, so we've got one side folded here. You just wanna keep the edges as lined up as possible. And like I said, always, always smoothing out any wrinkles that you feel. Those big wrinkles and creases will definitely have an effect on your design. So once I have this part done, you just grab a hold of it, hold onto it nice and tight so that the layers stay together, and flip it over. Turn it around here. Oh. Making a mess of things here. All right. Okay. That was all kinds of messy, so I'm gonna turn this back over. As I said, you may see me redoing some things here as I move through this process. So, thank you for watching. Thank you for your patience with me, especially if this video runs long and you watch the entire thing. I am very grateful for that support. All right, we're gonna try this again. Okay, this first edge is done. I'm just gonna try doing it this way instead. There we go. Perfect, okay. All right, so here's the back side. Bring this down. Just like we did on the other side, we're just gonna bring this down, line up the edge, smooth it out. Fold here. All right, so I'm all folded up, boom, just like that. This side, we've got 2 folds. This side, we've got 5 folds. like I said, you want to try and keep the edges as lined up as possible. That'll give you good symmetry in your design. And always, always, always smoothing out the wrinkles. So once I start tying this up, I tend to get pretty immersed in the work. I will explain what I'm doing as I go, but there will probably be some silence as well. So hope you enjoy the music. Like I said, we've got John Mayer playing in the background. There's our first commuter train. So lots of background noise for you today. All right, so I've got this all folded up. The next step is to do the center. So the center of this is where people like to tie with the sinew kind of tight and real close together. It gives you some really cool lines and cool design in the center. So I'm gonna start there. And then we'll move our way out. So again, this is the center of the mandala here. And then it'll have the rings throughout, and then this is the outer edge over here. So I'm gonna turn this around. Alright, so to tie this, you want to be able to tie it nice and tight. And so the best way to do that is to use waxed sinew. So that's what I'm going to use. Waxed sinew. It's great stuff. It's very strong. You can pull it really tight. And it helps you get the design you're looking for. So tied a slip knot in the sinew. I'm gonna try tying it by starting kind of up here and moving my way down to the end. If that doesn't work, then we will try something else. So, try to keep this where you guys can see what I'm doing. So I've got my slip knot here. I'm gonna set my hand down nice and firm on this and pull. And it starts to gather here. And then it releases. So, start again. It helps if you wrap it a couple of times, so that's what I'll do here. So I'm gonna wrap it once. Twice. There we go. All right. So this is where the dream catcher center kind of is gonna end. I think, let's see. Maybe not. Let's go a little further up, shall we? So. Third time's a charm. Okay, here we go. It helps to visualize what you want this to look like. Before you start tying, so that you kind of can plan out your lines and your ties. So let's see here. Think about here. We'll be good. Thank you. kind of pinching this as I pull it, just to get it nice and tight. And I'll be coming back up here, so I don't have to do it super tight yet. But I want it to hold. So wrap it 2 or 3 times and pull it. All right. Now I'm just gonna tie the sinew at an angle here. And basically I'm just gonna go back and forth in a little zigzag pattern with the sinew and pull it nice and tight every time. So see how this works for me. The idea is you don't want the sinew to separate here on the edge when you're tying it. So you don't want it to slip away from itself. So that's what I'm trying to avoid here. Like right now it's touching here, and as I pull, it will want to slip away from that spot, and that will create breaks in your pattern that you don't want. So let's try this again. I'm gonna hold it nice and tight with my finger here. Wrap it a couple of times. So you do this in the back, you make sure that it's lined up, pinch and pull. You can see that it's pulling away here, and that's what we don't want. So try again here. Also, you gotta watch, a lot of people use sinew pullers because if you pull on this the wrong way, your sinew will come right off the spool, and that sucks. So this is one of the parts of this where I said you guys will just have to kind of suffer along with me, is me trying to get this done. So, okay, let's try it again. Maybe third time will be a charm here as well. Yes. Okay, so now I'm gonna wrap it a couple more times and pull nice and tight. Okay, now we're gonna go the other way. As you can see, the sinew is starting to come off the end of my spool here, so I'm going to have to watch that. There we go. All right. So far, so good. Girls become lovers. and it helps if you pinch this and pull. You have to be careful because sinew can actually cut your fingers if you're not careful. It's very, very strong stuff and it can cut through your fingers. So it's good to have a way to pull it nice and tight and not use your fingers to do that. So. So here, there's just a little bit of separation, but it's not a lot. Probably won't affect the design. It's just, if I can get it to not separate, that's better. So I've got a spot back here where the sinew didn't stack on top of itself and the fabric is pinched in there and you don't want that. So you want the sinew to be lined up as perfectly as possible so that you don't pinch any fabric. Now there you can see that it really pulled away. We don't want that. So. There, now it's touching, and that's what you want. So, again, you want to try and keep your point good and keep your edges as close together as possible, so that your design looks good. Once you get into the center of it here, gets a little bit trickier. A lot of people use clips, binder clips, hair clips, all kinds of stuff to keep their edges together.
Thank you very much. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Okay. Next is this way. So we're just changing directions. We're just going back and forth. Changing directions to get that zigzag pattern. Wrap it a couple of times, pinch it, pull it, and it pulled away. So we unwrap and try again. got a little bit of separation there, but probably not enough to worry about. Again, pinching and pulling. Pinch, pull. It gives us nice tight ties. As we get down here towards the end, it's a little bit trickier. The sinew wants to slip more than it does when it's up higher. So sorry, I'm so quiet, guys. Like I said, I get pretty involved in what I'm doing here. Oh, goodness. That's all kinds of bad. Okay. Yes. Okay. Maybe one more. Okay, I feel pretty good about this. This will be the last one here. I'm so Okay. All right, so this is what we've got. Is we've got back and forth here. Hopefully you can see that. You got the center done. So now I'm just gonna go back up by just following the ties here. I'm not pulling, I'm not making them tighter or anything. I'm just making my way back up. You could cut the sinew and just start over up at the top, but there's no need for that, so. Okay. All right, so back up to our starting point here. This one I am gonna wrap a couple more times and pull. So we've got the back and forth here for the center of the mandala. And then I've got a straight line here, and that's gonna create a circle around the center before we go into our points and our offsets. So that's why the straight line is here. All right, guys. Thanks for bearing with me through that. I appreciate it. So the next step is to plan out our folds for the rest of this tapestry. So I have my washable marker here. A lot of people like to draw out their lines to use as guides before they even get started folding. People draw zigzags, they draw curved lines, they draw arches. The possibilities are endless. I'm just gonna do straight lines, and I'm only gonna do one line at a time, just because they're really meant as guides, and I would rather kind of let the folds happen a little bit more organically and let the fabric kind of guide me as far as where I should be folding. So you'll understand here as I go along. So again, I've got the two folds up here, and I've got the five folds down here. That's just what I have found so far from my limited experience and from the tutorials that I've seen online, the best way to proceed. So I'm gonna do, this is gonna be the first point coming off of the center. So I'm gonna do this. Just a line here like this. And like I said, a lot of people draw all their lines out. I'm not gonna do that with this. So what you do is you use this line as a guide and you do an accordion fold right along that line. So we've already kind of got an accordion fold started here just by the fabric being puckered. So I'm just gonna do this. Hopefully you guys can see what I'm doing here. Okay, so you do your little accordion fold here. If you look at it on the side, you've got a zigzag. Your line is lined up here. Kind of got to hold it nice and tight. And then you just bring your sinew down right along that line. You wrap it a couple of times. Hold it and pull. You can see it slipping away there. You can see the separation here. We don't want that. So I'm going going to put my finger here in an attempt to prevent that from happening. There we go. Wrap it a couple more times. Pull it nice and tight. All right. There we go. Okay, the next one is going to be in the opposite direction. So like this. And again, we're going to try to keep it touching here where we're changing direction. Make sure that the fabric's not pinched underneath. Pinch, pull. When you pull the sinew, you kind of can feel it locking on itself. You feel it kind of give a little bit. You feel it stretch, and then that stretch just stops and you get some resists. Okay. So, this is the first point. And this is the first offset, the space between the points. Now, like I said, a lot of people draw their guidelines. I could do that here. I could draw another line like this along here. And I can accordion fold that. But as you can see, the fabric is kind of already doing that for me. So just kind of let the fabric tell you what it wants to do. Let it kind of happen naturally. Got a zigzag here. That's what we're looking for. Okay, so I've got that lined up as best I can here. Touching here, so I'm just gonna pull. All right, so next we go in the opposite direction, and now I should be able to use that pleat there. All right, so far we've got the dream catcher here in the center, and then we've got our first point and our first offset and our second point and our second offset. So from here, we just continue this tie back and forth all the way down, and I'm gonna stop right here where the shorter pieces of fabric are underneath the top and bottom layer. So this is the center of the outer edge. And so I'm gonna stop there. Just like I wanted to draw my first point in this direction. So going from, when I drew the line, I went from the two folds down to the multiple folds. That's how you wanna end it as well. So just as a guide, I'm gonna draw this line. That's going to be my final fold when I get up to this point. So now that you've kind of seen the process, I'm going to speed this video up so that you guys don't have to suffer through the next 45 minutes of folding with me, and we'll be back. Okay, it's been probably about 30 minutes or so, and I've got this all full or all tied up. So again, we've got the center here, got the first point offset. So back and forth here are the points of the mandala and then the offset spaces between the points. So when you get down to the end here, we're right at the end where the fabric ends in those middle layers. You can do pretty much whatever you want with this. A lot of people scrunch it. Some people, pleat it or do a little spiral or whatever you want to do. You can do pretty much anything. I'm just going to kind of gather it up here like so. And I'm just going to wrap the sinew around it loosely to hold it in place. So it's the last step here. Work these pleats a little bit. And again, this is just to hold the fabric in place. We're not looking for any kind of tight tie or anything here. So the nice thing about sinew is you don't have to tie a knot in it. It's got the wax on it. So when you pull it nice and tight, it sticks to itself. And then you can just cut it off and it stays in place. And this gives me something to grab onto when I go to unwrap it. So so that's kind of cool. Just gonna play around with this a little bit here. And I actually kind of like the idea of that scrunched up a little bit. So let's play with that idea for just a minute. Okay, so I've decided that I'm just gonna scrunch this. So I just kind of separated the layers a little bit here. And then I'm just gonna scrunch it up like so. So I'm gonna do this. Close to done, guys. Again, I really appreciate you sticking with me through this. Okay, guys, it's done. So, the other tapestry that I did not scrunch the end like this. I kept the pleats kind of in place and just wrapped it like I had started to do with this one. So, we'll get to see, what the different choices there bring us as far as results go. So if you've stuck with me through this whole thing, I appreciate it so much. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking it out with me. I know it was a long video. Hopefully you learned something and hopefully you were entertained and enjoyed the music when I fell into my moments of silence there. So we're gonna put some dye on this and some ice and let it batch. And then we'll do a rinse and reveal of both of these when they are ready to go. So this is the mandala that I just folded for this video, and I decided that I'm going to include the placement of the die in the video as well and just make it an all-in-one video. So I've got the mandala all set up in my bin and ready to die. I've got all my dies laid out here. I've decided to do a rainbow design on this. So I chose the colors. I used my color swatches and chose colors that I think are gonna look good together and blend well. And then I've chosen this one, Wedgwood Blue, for the outer edge and the center. So I'm gonna put the Wedgwood Blue in the center, and then I'm gonna do a rainbow sequence through here. And it's actually gonna be twice that it goes through here. And then I'm gonna use the Wedgwood Blue down here on the end as well. So we're gonna have a double rainbow surrounded by stormy sky is kind of what I'm envisioning. So we'll see how it goes. I'm going to get the camera set up and then I'll get started with the dye. So I decided to speed up this part of the video because it took me about 20 minutes to place the die down on the tapestry. And so I thought I would just speed it up and kind of walk you through what I did here. So all of my dies are from Dharma Trading Company. So that's where I get all of my dies. I started with the center and the opposite end where the pattern is scrunched. And on those sections, I used Wedgwood Blue to give me that stormy sky that I'm hoping for. After I did those sections, I started the mandala itself and the rainbow sequence with grape. And then I counted out the number of sections that I had based on the number of colors I was using, and grape went into this middle section as well. And then there was one extra section down at the end, just before the scrunched area. So I decided to end with grape as well, because I don't think you can ever have too much purple. So there are three sections on the mandala that got the grape, and then all the other colors were just two sections. So after the purple, I did fuchsia, and I decided to layer a little bit of hot pink on top of the fuchsia. I do like to layer my dye powders sometimes because it gives some nice depth and some cool blending if you use colors that blend well together. So fuchsia and hot pink were the colors that I used on these sections. Then I used Chinese red, and I used that by itself. Chinese red is a great red. It's a very bright, true red. After the red, I used deep orange on the next sections. Another great color, really vibrant. I always love the way the deep orange looks on fabric. After the orange, I went to yellows. So I layered here. I started with lemon yellow, which is a very bright yellow. And then just to warm it up a little bit, I decided to add just a little bit of golden yellow on top of the lemon yellow. So lemon yellow first, and then a little bit of golden yellow. After the yellow, I went to green. I started with new emerald green. And then I decided to make the green pop a little bit and added electric green on top of the new emerald green. So here you see me laying down the new emerald green, and then on top of that, the bright green, or the electric green rather. The final sections got turquoise, and then those were topped with peacock blue. And that is how the die was placed on this tapestry. All right, guys, this is the first tapestry of the two that I did for this video. I ice dyed this yesterday, so I folded it and put the ice and the dye on it yesterday. So it's been batching for 24 hours. It is time to rinse it out and show you what it looks like. So let's get that done. Okay, guys, here it is. It has been rinsed, and we are going to unfold it and see what it looks like. My husband is behind the camera, ready to adjust the focus as necessary. So this is the first time I've ever revealed something without seeing it first. So I'm nervous and excited at the same time. Okay. So here it is. This is our first full size tapestry. And from back here, it looks really cool. Husband, how does it look? He gave me a thumbs up. Apparently he doesn't want to talk on camera. So obviously this is darker than it's going to be in the end. Like we're going to have to rinse it some more. There's still quite a bit of excess dye in it. So I will rinse it out some more and then we'll run it through a wash in the washing machine and dry it and iron it. And I will post a picture of it when it's all finished. But I think it looks pretty good, guys. I'm excited. So as soon as the other one is done and ready to rinse out, I'll be back to show you that. Okay, we're back. It's been 24 hours since I tied this tapestry for the video and dyed it. So it is time to rinse it out. So that's what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna speed this up while I rinse it and then I'll be back to show you how it looks. Hey everybody, here is the rainbow mandala tapestry that I did. When I went to record the video to reveal this to you, my camera decided to be wonky and the quality of the video sucked. So we're just gonna do it again. I've already seen this, but you haven't, obviously. So I'm gonna show you what it looks like. So this has been washed and dried. And I just kind of refolded it the way it was folded before I rinsed it. So take a look here. So this is it. This is our rainbow mandala tapestry. Like I said, it's been washed and dried. So this is the pretty much the final result. I think it came out great. Very excited about it. So thanks again so much for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to subscribe to my channel, you'll be notified of new videos. And of course, if you have any questions about these tapestries, feel free to leave your questions in the comments and I would be happy to answer them. Have a great day. See you next time.